Good morning everyone. Today we'll do English language in a quick revision part, that is standard 5, chapter 1, the sentence. And along with that, the passage is also given, which is given in page number 36 of your book. In this lesson, we have gone through the sentence in the online class, types of sentences, they are group of words, three parts are there, one is complete thought, and next two parts we'll look in the other side. Discussing about the complete thought, here we can see with an example I've explained that grass green is the, it doesn't convey any meaning, so we have to write it in a correct sequence, that is the grass is green, then only we can understand what the other person is trying to say, that is the color of the grass is green. In the second part, we see subject and a verb combination. So, sentence is also a subject and a verb combination. So, if I suppose say put the knife there, so here I did not explain you the subject, or I have told you the subject, but you can automatically understand that here I am talking to you, so here I have implied you. So, subject you and put is verb. So, here we can see is a combination of a subject and a verb. So you can also see the knife over here, which I have asked to put, that is put the knife there. Then is what is the sentence? Again, the third part is meaning. What's meaning? Statement, question, command, exclamation. How many types of sentences are there? Four: declarative, interrogative, imperative and exclamatory. Declarative is also known as assertive sentence. Let us see in detail declarative sentences which tell information, that is this mango is very tasty. So here we are talking about the mango which is very tasty. You can see the picture also. One girl, that she is a beautiful girl, that it is describing her quality, that she is very beautiful. So these all things like this comes in under declarative sentences. And interrogative sentences, of course, 5 WH questions, the WH words, that is who, what, when, where, why and whose. So plus H word is also there, that is how. So these are the question tags. Some examples of the question tags are given over here. Who are you? Why are you here? How is your brother? When did you come back? So these all are the examples of interrogative. Third is imperative sentence, which gives command or asks for request. Suppose I give you command, please shut the window. So this is a kind of command. If I give you in a command sense like give me a glass of milk, that is a command, but please shut the window is a request. Exclamatory sentence, where we express strong feelings, like when you are sad, when you are happy, when you are shocked or surprised, like if suppose very beautiful day it is, so you say what a beautiful day, you are happy today to see such a day. Or if suppose you win a match, you can say hooray, we won a match, or wow, we won a match. That is an expression which we are giving. So exclamatory sentences are the expressions, strong feelings or emotions. So children, this you need to copy down in your notebook. So and revise also, this is a, what is a sentence if it is asked, you have to write the three things, that is complete thought, subject and a verb combination and meaning. Under meaning these four are there, that is statement, question, command and exclamation, or exclamatory also we can say. So here a group of words which make a complete sense is called a sentence. So what is a sentence? Group of words which make a complete sense. In question 2, how many kinds of sentences are there? There are 4 kinds of sentences, that is declarative or assertive, which makes a statement. Then interrogative, which asks questions. Imperative, which expresses a command or a request. And lastly, exclamatory, which expresses a strong feeling or emotion. Here are all the answers given in this slide. That is exercise A of your page number 3. Then come to exercise B, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 words are given from which you have to make assertive, interrogative, imperative and exclamatory sentence. One I have shown over here how to do, and the rest 3, you have to do it on your own. And from here, exercise C also starts, that is, rearrange the following group of words into proper sentences. The type of sentence to be constructed is mentioned in the bracket that you have to follow and then solve it. So here is half part of the, that is 3 till 3, I have mentioned in this, written in this slide. Next, it will be continuing in the other slide. In this slide, you can see the continuation of exercise C and exercise B and revision exercise as homework which I have given. Here are the answers of your revision exercise that is given in page number 3 and 4. So you all can go through it and correct on your own. This is page number 4 from your book, that is first chapter. So here you have to mention S for sentence and T for phrase. It is done over here in practice part. Before starting the slide, let me say you that in page number 5 of your book, that exercise which is given, underline the phrases in the following sentences. Where number 1 is, Pam was playing with her friends, so with her friends will be underlined. Then grandpa is sitting under a shady tree, you have to underline. The parcels in the car are Christmas gifts in the car, you have to underline. Number 4 is, there are 50 students in my class, you have to underline. Number 5 is, Bruno came up to me wagging his tail, you have to underline. Number 6 is, the teacher told an interesting story, the teacher told. Number 7 will be, by 2 stallions, you have to underline. Number 8 will be, in the pool, you have to underline. Number 9, a cake, you have to underline. And number 10, a red car. Next, you will see the make sentences. You have to make the phrases. So, here I have shown you 5. And the rest, you have to do as your homework, which I have already discussed in our online class. Here in the slide, I have shown that in a sentence, 2 parts are there, that is subject and predicate, which I have shown with the help of an apple. I have divided the apple into 2 halves, showing subject and predicate. I have also given your example, which you can copy down in your notebooks. In page number 7, you will find that underline the subject and you have to circle the predicate, which is done. I hope you all must have done in your books. So better do it in the books and just check whether you have done it correctly or not. And the rest, whatever you have to do in the notebook and the books, that I have already mentioned earlier. Continuing on with the slide, here we will do comprehension, that is read and answer. Which is given in page number 36. And children, you have to write the entire passage from the book and then you have to copy down the questions and then you have to write the answers. And here I have given only the answers, but you have to write the questions also. This part I have already discussed in our online class also. So I hope everyone can follow that part.